you know, losing Carson was such a shock to the team. It's a month and a day since he was injured. What evidence have you seen that the team is over the shock of losing Carson Wentz?
I just think it, you know, it does take a little while when you lose your starting quarterback, obviously. I've said that before. But the fact, you know, these guys are you don't want to, I hate to even say it, but, you know, the game keeps going, you know. We still have to go to work the next day. Nick has to get himself ready to play. I've got to coach the next day. I've got to coach the next quarter. I got to coach the coach. You know, see, football's not going to stop. The games are not going to stop. You know, we have to get ready for the next week. So, you know, and as each day goes by, you get into the, you just like, okay, hey, we got to get ready for this week. We got to get ready for today's practice.
But why do you hate to say it? Is it because you don't want to disrespect
Carson? Well, I don't want to say, you know, I don't want to like discount the injury or the player or anything like that, but we've lost a lot of guys. We lost Jason Peters, and it was kind of the same mentality. Listen, the train's still kind of moving. Even though we're sick to our stomachs that these guys aren't with us, you know, out there on the field, the train's still moving. And the sooner we get over that, you know, and get on to the next order of business, the better we're going to become. And so, but that's a process. That doesn't happen overnight. You know what I'm saying? It takes a little time. Jason Peters, it takes a little time. You know, Darren Sproles, it takes a little time. Carson Wentz is going to take a little time. And so now we've had that time, you know, and moved on. And we, you know, have a great opportunity sitting here in front of us
today.
How
confident are you that you have moved on from Wentz?
I'm very confident in that. Just by the way the guys have handled their business the last 2 weeks, the way we practiced last week, the way we've prepared and prepped this week, does that guarantee anything? No. We still got to go out and play, but just the attitude of the team and focused on the opponent this week.
A couple more, please.
How has Carson's presence either grown or decreased since the early stages when he was doing rehab? Or he's getting more involved in the quarterback room with Nick?
You know, no, not really. I mean, he's still here in the morning, still in the early QB meetings, you know, in the morning. You know, he's still talking to Nick throughout the day, outside of the morning stuff. I mean, he's not in installation meetings. He, you know, it's rare that he even, you know, he's been out to practice, but that's about it. You know, he's just trying to get himself in a position where he can continue his rehab and feel comfortable doing that right now today.
I guess you kind of want him in the sense of that in the shadows so Nick can be out in front. We just talk about sort of having that divide of moving forward.
Yeah, you know, but at the same time, I still want Carson to be part of the process. I mean, he's a big reason why we're 13-3, you know, and where we are today. So, you know, same way with the rest of the guys. I do want them to feel a part of what we're doing and help their position.